Greetings. Brother, one of the biggest chasms between those who call themselves Muslim and the truth is a tragic form of bad logic that ignores context where pronouns apply. I would like to give you an example of the very bad behavior jihadis and Islamic defenders practice, so maybe you can understand. I am going to cite a surah which we both can clearly understand, even though we may not both agree it is true. Surah 61:6. And when Issa, son of Maryam, said, O children of Israel, surely I am the messenger of Allah to you. Here, the I is clearly this Issa character, and the you is clearly the children of Israel. So it is clear and obvious what this means. Verifying that which is before me of the Torah and giving the good news of a messenger who will come after me, his name being Ahmad. I think any rational person who can read and comprehend can understand the claim this text is making, even if we do not agree to its veracity. This ayat makes the claim that someone called Issa, son of Maryam, mentioned another man named Ahmad yet to come. But then we get to the half Islam completely misunderstands. And this is where the Islamic bad logic is applied in our example, brother. But when he, Ahmad, came to them with clear arguments, they said this is clear magic. See, brother, long before some Arab named Muhammad came and started Islam, a Jewish prophet named Ahmad came and worked miracles, fulfilling what this Issa, son of Maryam, character said. And the Jews rejected Ahmad in 427 AD and burned his scriptures, called the Qurap. So there are no traces of Ahmad's Qurap to this day. And it is so clear that this does not mean Muhammad and his Quran. But when he, Ahmad, came to them with clear arguments or signs, they said, this is clear magic. The Jews burned the Qurap because they thought Ahmad was a magician. And the more you think about it, this is a more clear sign than Muhammad's Quran. But when he, Ahmad, came to them with clear signs, they said, this is clear magic. See, Muhammad's Quran uses past tense to describe Ahmad bringing his Qurap already. Does that logic convince you, brother? Is Ahmad's Qurap different than Muhammad's Quran? So I hope you can understand, brother, there are two possible meanings to this ayat. And Islam has just got it wrong for 1400 years. You may have heard the one Islam claims, but when he, Issa, came to them with clear signs, they said this is clear magic. And the correct reading I now show, but when he, Ahmad, came to them with clear arguments, signs, they said this is clear magic. Do you understand the pronoun he creates an ambiguity? And while there are two meanings, honest scholarship is required to find the truth. I simply never find honest scholarship exhibited by anyone in Islam. And that proves to me Islam is a false path leading away from the truth. I want you to clearly understand, brother, this perfectly reflects the quality of logic Islam constantly applies handling the Torah and Bible. Books the Quran commands you to respect equal with Muhammad's Quran. Surah 2:136. We believe in Allah and that which was revealed to us, meaning the Quran, and that which was given to Musa or Moses, meaning the Torah, and Issa, the Gospel, the New Testament message, and that which was given to the prophets from their Lord, so the Tanakh, everything in between. We do not make any distinction between any of them. If you would honor the Torah and Bible as the Quran commands, you would take a big step toward the truth, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.